Hello. In continuation with the application of derivatives, today we will discuss about the approximations. What are approximations? Approximation by differentiation. Okay. One basic formula, let me tell you about the differentiation dy by dx or f dash x. Is equal to, you know that, f of x plus h minus f of x upon x plus h minus x. Okay, this is a formula, f dash x. F dash x is equal to f of x plus h. This h is what? It's a very smallest positive quantity. So we'll consider that the h is equal to delta x. So x plus delta x minus f of x upon xx cancel h, and h means it is delta x. Okay, I cross multiplied here. So what is coming? This f dash x into delta x is equal to f of x plus delta x minus f of x, and that means the value of f of x plus delta x is equal to f of x plus delta x multiplied by f dash x. Is it okay? So this is the relation between f of x plus delta x is equal to f of x plus delta x multiplied by f dash x. We'll use this formula for finding the approximate value with the help of differentiation. It's okay? So we wrote down this formula, f of x plus delta x. I'm writing here, f of x plus delta x is equal to f of x plus f dash x multiplied by delta x. Okay, delta x is smallest value. Okay, so we'll use this formula for finding the approximate value, which is a differentiation method, and this is a method by which we are not going to find the square root, we are going to find the approximate value of any term which is given in a form of function. So I start exercise 6.4. Exercise 6.4, using differentiations, find the approximate value of each of the following up to 3 decimal places. Okay, exercise 6.4. Exercise 6.4, first question, taking first part of it. There are many parts. There are total 15 parts in first question. Using differentials, first question is under root 25.3. This is a question. And we are going to find the approximate value of it. Not exact value, we are going to find the approximate value. Because it is a rational number, we cannot find its perfect value. But approximate value we can find out. It's okay. As I told you, this formula will be applicable here. 25.3. First, you understand this term. Under root 25.3. May I write here 25 plus 0.3? Why is it? Because we know that the square root of 25 is 5. Okay. So we will have to write this term into the form of the two terms, sum of two terms, in such a way that the first term having the complete square of the term, square root of the term. So 25.3 is equal to 25 plus 0.3. And you know that the square root of 25 is 5. Okay. So that means its answer is 5 point something. Some positive value will be there. And now let us check which value will be with that 5. 25 plus 0.3. Okay. So what is this? X is equal to 25. And delta X is equal to 0.3. Small approximate value, after decimals very small value is considered as a, so delta x is equal to 0.3. Okay, we're using this formula, f of x plus delta x is equal to f of x plus f dash x multiplied by delta x. In this formula, you'll see that how many things are required. One is f of x, so okay, no problem, we can find out f dash x. That means the differentiation of this term. Okay, multiplied by delta x. X is equal to 25 I have taken. So we'll consider here, let y is equal to under root x. Because this term in the form of under root, so we will consider any variable in the form of this, y is equal to under root x. Differentiate with respect to x. So you're getting y r dy by dx is equal to the differentiation of root x is 1 upon 2 under root x. And the value of dy by dx, what does it mean? It is f dash x. So f dash x is equal to 1 upon 2 root x. Okay. Now we got every value from here. Now f of x plus delta x. So f of x plus delta x, that means under root 25.3. is equal to, in this formula, f of x. What is f of x? F of x, that means under root 25. Under root 25. X 25 f of x. Plus f dash x multiplied by delta x. What is f dash x? F dash x is 1 upon 2 root x. 1 upon 2 root 25 multiplied by delta x. What is delta x? 0.3. Is it okay? Substitute all the values here. 25.3 is equal to square root of 25. We know that 5, because that's why we have broken this 25.3 into two parts. One is 25, so that it will become a perfect square root of 25. 5 plus 1 upon 2 multiplied by 5, 0.3. So that means it is 5 plus 0.3 upon 5 2 is 10. So the result is 5 plus 0.3 divided by 10, 0.03. So finally, 25.3 is equal to 5. When we add 5 plus 0.03, it is 5.03. So this is the value of 25.3. It's okay. So in all the questions, we have to use this formula and put the value accordingly. One is f of x, f dash x. Clear? First question, after first part, we want to take a question in which subtraction is there, that means the delta x should be negative, okay? I am selecting fourth part of it. Fourth part. That is 0.009 to the power 1 upon 3. To the power 1 upon 3. Find the approximate value of it. 0.009. It's very close to 1. Okay. So right here. X is equal to this 0.009 can be written in the form of 1 minus 0.001. Is that okay? You can see 1.000, 0.001. 10 minus 1, 9, it is 9. Sorry, 10 minus 1, it is 9. This is coming 9 and it is also 9. So 0 point, no, we cannot write it like this. 0.009 it is not very close to 1. It is, I think, very close to, this cannot be, you cannot write like this. Okay, so it is coming 0.99 something, so that we can write here. Because 1 upon 3 is there. And 1 upon 3, what does it mean? 2 to the 4 to the 8. Okay. So may I write this term in the form of, I wanted to select a negative term. But okay, let us solve this. 0.008 plus 0.001. Is it okay? 0.009 addition to the power 1 by 3. And you know that 0.008 is there to the power 1 by 3. Its value is coming 0.2. Okay. Perfect cube. Cube root of 0.0088 0.2. So this we can take it. That means we can break into two parts. 0.008 plus 0.001 to the power 1 by 3. Now here x is equal to 0.008. Delta x is equal to 0.001. Okay. Formula f of x plus delta x is equal to f of x plus f dash x multiplied by delta x. Okay. We need f dash x. So this is f of x is equal to, where right here, x to the power 1 by 3. Here you don't understand that this x is equal to 0.008 to the power 1 by 3. It's a variable. Y is equal to variable to the power 1 by 3. So here we have to treat as a variable. So f of x is equal to x to the power 1 by 3. Differentiate with respect to x. F dash x is equal to x to the power 1 by 3. It is coming 1 upon 3. X to the power 1 upon 3 minus 1. So what does it mean? 1 upon 3 x to the power minus 2 upon 3. And that means 1 upon 3 x to the power 2 by 3. Okay. 1 minus 3 upon minus 2. That means it is 2 by 3. This is the value of f dash x. Now I'll put the value in it. F of x plus delta x, so direct you can write here 0.009 to the power 1 by 3 is equal to f of x. The value of f of x is 0.008 to the power 1 by 3, okay, plus f dash x, 1 upon 3 x 0.008 to the power 2 by 3 multiplied by delta x. Delta x is 0.001. Is that okay? The substitution. After that, 0.008 to the power 1 by 3, may I write here 0.2? 0.2 multiplied by 0.2 multiplied by 0.2, 2 to the 4 to the 8, and decimal after decimal, there are 3 numbers, 1, 2, 3. Plus 1 upon 3. This term can be written 0.2 raised to the power 3 and to the power 2 by 3 multiplied by 0.001. So 0.2 plus 1 upon 3 cancel. 0.2 multiplied by 2. 0.2 multiplied by 0.2, 0.04 into 0.001. Okay. So that means it is 0.2 plus 0.001 upon 4 3s are 12, 0.12. okay, here we are going to solve it. 0.001 divided by 12. How to solve this portion? 1 upon 30 coming here, 20 here, that means it is 1 upon 120 direct. When you remove this decimal, after decimal 1 2 3, so 1000 is coming here, after decimal there are 20, 100 is coming here, 20 cancel, so 1 upon 120, 0.2 plus 1 upon 120. Okay, 1 upon 120. So let us divide 120.00, still 10. Okay, this is 12, 8 ja 96, 960, it is 40, 0, 12, 3 ja 36. And 40 is the coming 0.0083. So when I write here, this means 0.2 plus 0.0083. Okay, what is the sum of that? 0.2000 and 0.0083. So it is coming 3802.0. 0.2083. Okay. This is the approximate value of 0.009 to the power 1 by 3. Okay. This formula remains there only till the exercise is over. Now selecting a question. Yes, got it. 255 to the power 1 by 4. Question is number 8 question. Almost all the questions are same type. 255 to the power 1 by 4. 255 to the power 1 by 4. This is the question. Okay. Find the approximate value of it. Here what happened, 1 upon 4, so 255 may write here 256 minus 1, because 256, you can see here, make a prime factor of 2 1 is 2, 2 2 is 4, 2 8 is 16, 64, 2 32, 2 16, 2 8, 2 4, 2 2 and then 2 1, so 1 pair and it is 2 pair 4. So may I write here 256 can be written 4 to the power 3, 4 to the power 4, 4 to the power 4, okay. So that term can be written 256 minus 1 to the power 1 by 4, okay. Why we have written in this way? So that 256 to the power 1 by 4, its value is direct 4, okay. So break it 2 point, x is equal to 256. And delta x is equal to minus 1. Remember this. Delta x is equal to minus 1. Because 256 plus minus 1. So this is the small change. Delta x is equal to minus 1. Okay. And we need first f dash x is required. So f of x is equal to, may I write here, x to the power 1 by 4. Differentiate with respect to x. F dash x is equal to 1 upon 4 x to the power 1 upon 4 minus 1. So 1 upon 4 x to the power minus 3 upon 4. And that means 1 upon 4 x to the power 3 upon 4. Okay. Formula f of x plus delta x is equal to f of x plus f dash x multiplied by delta x. F of x plus x 255 to the power 1 by 4 is equal to f of x. The value of f of x is equal to 256 raised to the power 1 by 4 plus f dash x 1 upon 4 x 256 to the power 3 by 4 multiplied by delta x. The value of delta x is not plus 1, it is minus 1. Okay. This can be written as a 4 plus 1 upon 4. This is 4 to the power 4 multiplied by 3 by 4 into minus 1. So that means 4 plus this 4 and 4 cancel, 4 to the power 3, 4 4 is 16, 4 is 64, 1 upon 4 multiplied by 64 into minus 1, okay, 4 plus minus minus 1 upon 64, 4 jump, 256, okay, 1 upon 256, so when we divide, 0.00000 256 4 ja it's more than, so it's 3 ja 6 3 ja 18 1 3 5 ja 15 1 16 1 3 2 ja 6 1 7 2 9 minus 6 3 and it is 8 sorry 9 minus 7 2 232 and it is coming I think 9 2 5 6 0 9 ja 9 6 ja 54 5 9 5 ja 45 55 9 to 18 523 0.0039 4 minus 0.0039, okay, so that means 4.0000 and 0.0039, okay, result is 10 minus 9 1 9 minus 3 6 9 9.3, okay, 3.9961 9 1 10 10, it is 10, 10, okay, 3.9961, 3.9961. This is the approximate value of 255 to the power 1 by 4. Okay. So now I think you have understood whether that delta x is positive or negative. Same rule will be applied here. When there is a negative, so we will put here minus sign and subtract the term. Positive, then we are going to add the term. Okay. So I think all the questions, all 15 questions, 15 parts of question number 1 are of same type questions. One question is given, number 5th, 0.999. 0.9 can be written 1 minus 0.001. Okay. So 1 minus 0.001. It's all like that. So I hope these 15 questions, I think you can solve all the 15. Coming to the second question of it. Find the approximate value of, this is the question, find the approximate value, find the approximate value of f 2.01 is equal to f 2.01, where the function is given f of x is equal to f of x is equal to 4x square plus 5x plus 2. Okay. This is the question. Find the approximate value of f of 2.01 when f of x is equal to this. Okay. No worry about this question. F of x is equal to 4x square plus 5x plus 2 is there. We'll use the same formula. In this formula, we need f dash x. So first of all, we are finding differentiate with respect to x. F of x becomes f dash x is equal to 8x plus 5. Constant term 2, differentiation is 0, f dash x. Okay. Formula f of x plus delta x is equal to f of x plus f dash x multiplied by delta x. Okay. F of 2.01 is equal to f of x. The value of f of x is 4x square plus 5x plus 2. 4x square. What is the value of x? F 2.01. So x is equal to 2 and delta x is equal to 0.01. Okay. In place of x, I want to put here 2. So it's 2 square plus 5 into 2 plus 2. Okay. This is the value of f of x plus f dash x. What is f dash x? 8x, 2 plus 5, f dash x multiplied by delta x. And what is delta x? 0.01. Okay. So 2 2 is 4, 4 4 is 16, plus 5 2 is 10, plus 2. This is a different term. Put bracket over here. Plus 8 to the 16, 16 plus 5, 21, multiplied by 0.01. Okay. 16, 26, 28, plus 21 multiplied by 0.1, 0.21. And 28 plus 0.21, the result is 28.21. So this is the value of f of 2.01. Okay. So I think one thing which you have understood, that in each and every question we have to use this formula which I told you, f of x plus delta x is equal to f of x plus f dash x multiplied by delta x. Okay. But in some questions direct we can use the differentiation in both sides. Okay. When the rate of change is given. Like
Question number third can be done by you at the simple end as same question like question number two. Now coming to question number four.
Fourth question. What is it?
This is find the approximate change in the volume V of the cube of a side X meter caused by increasing the side by 1%.
Okay.
Find the approximate change in the volume, and volume is given V.
Volume V and
side X meters.
Side is equal to X meters.
Side X meters caused by increasing the side by 1%.
Increasing side by 1%. Okay.
Side is increasing by 1%. And what is it? Approximate change in the volume V of a cube.
Okay.
You are aware of that the volume of cube is?
Sir, I use the formula.
The question is clear. The volume of cube, find the approximate change in the volume of cube when the side X meter is increased 1%.
Okay.
Volume of cube is equal to A cube, H cube. So I write here V is equal to X cube.
Okay.
V is equal to X cube. Simply they are asking that find the change in the volume. And change in the volume, what does it mean? dV.
Okay.
So I'm going to differentiate with respect to x. So I write here dv is equal to 3x square dx. Okay. Find that dv by dx is equal to 3x square. Same thing. dv is equal to 3x square into dx. This is the small change, 1% change. So dv is equal to 3 and x square, this remains as it is, dx. Dx, what does it mean? It is change of 1% increasing.
Okay.
This is increased. The volume is increased of the side by 1%. Cause the increasing the side by 1%.
Okay.
Find the approximate change in the volume V of the cube side X meter caused by increasing the side by 1%. Side is increasing by 1%. So that is delta X. What does it mean? Dx is equal to 1 upon 100 into x. Okay, this is the increment of the side. So dv is equal to 3 upon 100 x square into x. It is x cube. So 0.03 x cube centimeter cube per second.
Okay,
it is the rate of change or the volume of change centimeter cube per second, or simply per second. If you don't want to write, simply write here centimeter cube.
Okay.
And not centimeter, it is given in the form of meter. So it is meter cube.
Okay.
So change the volume is 0.03 x cube meter cube. By the way, when we are talking about the change the volume, that means meter cube per second. It's okay. So this is the changing. That means when the side is changing 1%, then the volume is changing 0.03 x cube.
Okay.
Now other questions of this type of question, that means in the change, increasing, decreasing, like that. This is one question, number 6. If the radius of the sphere is measured as 7 meter with an error of 0.02 meter, then find the approximate error in calculating its volume.
Okay. Question number 6.
If the radius of a sphere of measured as 7 meter,
radius of a sphere,
is equal to r is equal to 7 meter. Okay. Or I'll take x because we'll differentiate with respect to x. X 7 meter with an error of 0.02 meter. Error 0.02 meter. This is an error. Then find the approximate error in calculating its volume. Okay. Approximate error in calculating volume, it is a sphere. So we'll write here the volume of a sphere. Volume of a sphere is equal to, what is the formula of volume of a sphere? 4 upon 3 pi r cube. Okay. So volume of a sphere V is equal to 4 upon 3 pi x cube. Okay. What they are asking? They are asking change in volume. Or change in volume, change in what is the error? Error in volume. So for finding the error in volume, what should be written? Again, differentiate with respect to x. What to write here? dv is equal to 4 upon 3 pi, 4 upon 3 pi constant, and differentiation of x cube is 3x square dx. 3, 3 cancel. dv is equal to 4 pi x square into dx. Okay, this is dv, what does it mean? Error in volume. Okay, because the error is given 0.02 meter. So here what's right to dv is equal to 4 pi x. Side is given 7. So in place of x, y right here 7 square into dx. The error is 0.02. So therefore dv is equal to 4 pi, 7, 7 is 49 multiplied by 0.02. 45 2s are 98, 4 multiplied by 98, and in decimal 0 is here, this is pi. So I write here 4 multiplied by 0.98, and pi is 22 upon 7. We can cancel it. 7 1 7, 2 7 4 ja 28. So 4 multiplied by 4 multiplied by the decimal is here, 22 multiplied by 14. 14 2s are 28, 2, 14 2s are 28 to 30. And after decimal, there are two numbers, 3.08 and 3.08, which is multiplied by 3.08, it is multiplied by 4. Okay. 8 4 is 32, 4 3 is 12, 12.32. Okay. So that means the error in volume is meter cube. 12.32 meter cube. This is the error in volume. Okay. Okay, 98 multiplied by 49 2s are 98, 0.98, 0.98, 22 upon 7, 7 cancel 14 point, okay, 14 2s are 28, 2, 40 28, 30, 3.08 multiplied by 4, 12.32. okay, after this question, taking one more question of this exercise, this is number 7. If the radius of the sphere is measured as a 9 meter with an error of 0.03 meter, then find the approximate error in calculating its surface area. I think the same type of question. What is given? Seventh question. Radius of a sphere. Is equal to, x is equal to, I am taking this as x, 9 meter. okay, with an error of 0.03 meter. This is an error of 0.03. Approximate error and calculate its surface area. Surface area of sphere. Surface area of sphere. What is it? Surface area of sphere 4 pi r square. Formula. Surface area is denoted by generally S is equal to 4 pi x square. Okay. Differentiate with respect to x. So what is coming? Ds is equal to 4 pi and differentiation of x square is 2x dx. So ds is equal to 4 pi into 2. The value of x is 9 and delta x is 0.03. okay, so it is coming 9 to the 18, 18 3 ja 4 pi multiplied by 9 to the 18, 18 3 ja 54, 0.54, 4 4 ja 16, 1, 4 5 ja 20, 21. After decimal there are two places, two number 2.16, and this is pi. So when I put the value pi, 22 upon 7 also, 7 3 is 20, but it is not cancelable. Okay, so simply we will write here 2.16 ds is equal to 2.16. if the value of pi 22 upon 7, 7 is not cancelable here properly, so in place of 22 upon 7 we can put 3.14. okay, both the values are same. 2.16 multiplied by 3.1. 6 4 is 24, 2, 4 1 is 4, 2, 6, 4 2 is 8, 6, 1, 2, 3, 6 is 18, 3 1 is 3, 4 and 6, 4, 12, 16, 17, 1, 18, 6, 1, 7, 6, 6, 7, 8, 4, 2. So ds is equal to 6, 7, 8, 4, 2. After decimal there are 4 number, 2 plus 2, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. 6.7842 meter square change in error. Okay, so that is question number 7. So I think this is the end of this exercise. I hope remaining questions will be solved by you. Okay, in my next lecture we'll have to start maxima and minima. It's a very interesting chapter. Okay, so wait till the next chapter will start. Thank you and thanks for watching my channel.